A female suicide bomber blew herself up in Paris today as police closed in. Meanwhile, ISIS has threatened to attack Washington, D.C., and there's a lot of concern that terrorists will try to strike the United States during the upcoming holidays. Here with more on escalating ISIS concerns since the Paris attack is CBN News terrorism analyst Eric Stackelbeck. Well, the hunt is on for members of the terrorist cell in France, Eric. Clearly, there are more terrorists out there. How likely is another attack in France?
It's highly likely for a few reasons, Lurie, and I hate to say that, but number one, look, if you still have members of this cell, suspects on the ground, on the loose, basically, they could be feeling a sense of desperation right now. If they feel their time is short, that they're possibly ready to be arrested, they may want to carry something out in the short window of time they have left. That's number one. Number two, remember, some 1,500 French citizens have left their homes there, gone to Iraq and Syria to join ISIS. And now the trickle home is going on, Lurie. We're seeing more and more of these battle-tested jihadis return to European countries like France. So not only in the short term is France in danger of attacks, but in the long term, as this trickle of foreign fighters continues to return home.
Well, what about here in the United States? How serious is the threat of terrorism from ISIS as Thanksgiving travel ramps up?
Extremely serious, Lurie. Look, and it's not just me saying it. If you listen to Obama administration officials, you have the director of the FBI, James Comey, saying there are 900 cases right now active into ISIS-related activity in all 50 states. So that's some serious stuff, and that's an Obama administration official saying it. And yes, with the holiday shopping season, Lurie, look, Thanksgiving, obviously, Black Friday, huge shopping day, right? The Christmas shopping season coming. These are, unfortunately, prime targets, shopping malls, soft targets with innocent people there just going about their business. These are absolutely prime targets, symbolic with Christmas, a Christian holiday, obviously symbolic for ISIS to strike then.
Well, Eric, a lot of people were really surprised in the wake of the Paris terrorist attacks that President Obama said there's really no need to change the U.S. strategy in the fight against ISIS. What's your response to that?
Well, I think he's wrong. I think he's wrong on this and many other issues when it comes to national security, foreign policy, and in particular the Middle East, Lurie. Look, if you look at our strategy, by the way, President Obama said several times, as recently as several months ago, that we don't have a strategy yet. Now, apparently, we do. What that strategy is hasn't really been clearly defined beyond limited U.S. airstrikes. So we have the French, for instance. After last Friday's horrific attacks, France bombing major targets in Raqqa, Syria. Raqqa is basically ISIS's capital, the capital of their caliphate. Why aren't we doing that? Why hasn't the United States taking out these jihadi training camps in Raqqa, these ISIS strongholds there? Why is Syria doing it? France doing it? Why is Russia doing it? We are the leader of the free world. Why are we not leading the way in the fight against ISIS? That's a question President Obama can't answer. And frankly, Lurie, he hasn't even defined the strategy, which is no surprise because he can't define the enemy. Jihadism, radical Islam. It's really easy. We need to say it if we want to defeat it.
Well, there's also renewed concern, very serious concern now over the migrants and refugees trying to come to the United States from Syria and Iraq. Do you think we have a sufficient vetting process to weed out potential terrorists from the mix?
I don't, Lurie. Look, better than Europe, where the open borders issue there is insane, quite frankly. But here in the U.S., again, I'll cite Obama administration officials. Number one, FBI Director James Comey said, yeah, it's going to be tough to vet all of these folks coming into the United States from Syria and other jihadi hotbeds. The FBI director, again, saying that. And the Department of Homeland Security chief, Jay Johnson, said recently, yes, it's going to be difficult to vet all of these folks coming in. So when Obama administration officials are saying that, I think we need to have cause for concern. And two things here, Lurie. Number one, the sheer volume of refugees. Europe, obviously, hundreds of thousands flooding the borders of Europe. But here in the U.S., 10,000 in 2016, but President Obama's looking to up that number to 100,000 coming in 2017 and beyond. So it's a major wave. This isn't just a trickle. It's a large group of people. The larger the group, obviously, Lurie, the harder to vet. And number two, they're coming from war zones like Syria, which are obviously jihadi hotbeds. But look, these are war zones. Do they have proper identification? How can you vet them? How can you look into their track record, their past, if they really don't have any documentation? It's an open question.
Well, Eric, it's just so disturbing that many of the ISIS fighters, and as you mentioned, even the terrorists in Paris, were actually born or grew up in the West. Is the United States doing anything to counter the radicalization of Muslims already living in our country?
Not enough, Lurie. Look, the House Homeland Security Committee, not far from where I'm sitting here in Washington, released a report back in September saying that our government is not doing enough to stem the flow of people who are becoming radicalized and going overseas to join ISIS in Iraq and Syria. Now, the Obama administration has a program called Countering Violent Extremism. They won't use the term radical Islam. They only call it violent extremism. And what they're doing, Lurie, is they're going to different hotspots, places like Minneapolis, New York City, Columbus, Ohio, of all places, Boston, where we've had terror cells busted. And they're going there and they're trying to network and do outreach with the Muslim leaders there. But in my view, Lurie, and I've reported on this on CBN News, our outreach efforts to the Muslim community here in the United States, we're targeting the wrong people. Many times we're targeting imams and mosques with ties to the Muslim Brotherhood. There are genuinely moderate Muslims here in the U.S., but unfortunately, the folks that the Obama administration is bringing to the table are radical Islamists themselves.
Well, thanks, Eric, for updating us on so many different aspects of the terrorism issue as it stands today. We'll talk to you again soon.
Thanks, Lurie. Sure thing.